Hi, and welcome to another episode of Legal Tuesdays. I'm Monica Miller, the Legal Director and Senior Counsel for the American Humanist Association. On this episode today, I'm going to talk a little bit about evolution. We received a question from a member who says, is it legal to teach that evolution is impossible in a public school? About 10 years ago, my two children came home from their high school biology class stating that the teacher told them it was just about impossible for evolution to have happened. Is this unconstitutional? Yes, it is. When public school teachers are on school grounds during instructional hours, they are forbidden by the Establishment Clause from endorsing religion. That includes weighing in on a topic that, such as evolution, where they're inserting their religious perspective on it rather than the secular scientific one. The Supreme Court has ruled several times in various ways that public school teachers are forbidden from expressing not only their personal religious views to students, but specifically on the subject of evolution. In the Epperson versus Arkansas case, the Supreme Court struck down a statute that said that whenever evolution is taught in the public schools, they also need to offer something about creation science. And the Supreme Court struck that down, saying the purpose of this is to promote a religious view, creationism. And so really, when it comes to evolution, there cannot be in the public schools this alternative side because it's anti-science, it's pro-religion. So there's cases hailing from all the circuits dealing with public school teachers doing far less egregious things. I guess if you put it in perspective, denying science as a humanist, to me, denying science and failing to educate students about facts, about science, is one of the most egregious things I can think of in a public school context outside of, you know, physical abuse and that kind of stuff. Their minds are vulnerable. They're there to learn, and spreading religious claims that belie science just doesn't comport with our understanding of what the public school system is meant to do. And it also belies the separation of church and state at the heart of the First Amendment. So yes, what I was saying is there's circuit court decisions involving, say, in the Fifth Circuit, there was a series of cases involving a coach who would silently take a knee when his basketball players would pray before basketball games. They said even though he was silent and just being respectful and bending his knee, that signaled endorsement of the religious views of the students and therefore unconstitutional. The Third Circuit had a similar ruling where a coach was also just being a silent participant in a prayer circle and was found to be unconstitutional. The Ninth Circuit had a case, Peloza versus Capistrano School District. And in that, the court said all sorts of stuff about what teachers can and can't do during school hours. But they said even just discussing religion with your students during school time is not just inappropriate, it's unconstitutional. And I think that that teacher was also specifically making statements about evolution. There was a Connecticut district court decision where a teacher was wearing Jesus 2000 sweatshirt or some sort of garb at school. And the court said it was sort of a reversed case where I think the school had told the teacher they need to take off the religious sweatshirt or t-shirt, and the teacher refused on First Amendment grounds, and the court said, consistent with all these other cases, that not only would the teacher not have a First Amendment right to express his or her religious views to students during school on public school campus, but also that doing so runs afoul of the Establishment Clause. It might not necessarily have amounted to a full-blown violation there, especially because the teacher was acting ostensibly outside of school policy because the school took appropriate action, so it'd be hard to challenge the school district for taking those measures with respect to the teacher, say if she went against the school and wore the shirt again. As long as the school continues to reprimand the teacher, they're doing their job. Well, I guess if the teacher continues to violate the Constitution, then they would need to take more serious measures. So yes, it is unconstitutional for a teacher to denounce science to public school students, and doing so repeatedly would certainly amount to a constitutional violation.